Good morning, everyone. Bright and early. It's about 6 a.m. here, and welcome to part 11 of Extra Life 2014, in which we finally put Dead Space to rest, I certainly hope. We have a little less than 3 hours to go in this whole shindig, so let's make the most time of it as we can. If at this point you don't know what Extra Life is about, I honestly don't know how to help you. Everything you need to know is on the website you see in front of you. You can read about it there. Ta-da! Okay. Let's jump back into the game. If you're just tuning in, currently we're on our way to fix the shuttle, which will hopefully give us a way out of this place. Even though others want us to repurpose it for other things.
Firing shuttle engines.
Come on.
trying to find a stasis recharge station of some kind. Because that's the only way that that other thing makes sense. Yeah, I just have to get really lucky with timing.
I'm on my way.
Test firing shuttle engines.
Test firing shuttle engines. me. I'm on my way.
Test firing shuttle engines.
Actually did that right.
It works. Yes, this will work. There's still time to make things right. The shuttle needs to be released before launch. The control platform there. I need you to guide the undocking procedure while I start the shuttle's engines. I'll take the shuttle up to the flight deck where the marker's being held.
Shuttle locks disengaged.
I'm en route to the flight deck. Meet me there and we can load the marker on board. Yes, Amelia. Soon we'll take it home.
I don't know if Kind is crazy or not, but we need that shuttle. Let's keep him on our side. For now.
Your time has come. No need to be frightened. No reason to fight. Many have gone before us, and now it's time for us to take the voyage together. Transcend death. The future take its course. Join me as I gaze upon the face of God.
Alrighty, just two more chapters left to go.
Mr. Clark, I'm approaching the shuttle hangar. You must find your way to the cargo bay. The marker, it's being stored in there. There's a cargo loading lift there you can use to deliver the marker up to the hangar. Please, you must help me with this. It's the only way.
cargo shipment 782. Kinesis module required for further transport.
Thank you.
restored power to the elevator. Take it up to the hangar bay and get the marker on the shuttle. I'm heading up to the flight deck now. Oh god. I'm just gonna run for it. Wish me luck.
I'm going to dock the shuttle. Got to be careful now. Careful. I'm bringing the shuttle down now. The automated loading controls aren't responding. You'll have to shut down gravity in the hangar bay, and then manually bring the marker directly beneath the shuttle. Zero gravity. Okay, it's in position. Still having trouble with these damn loading controls. Isaac, restore gravity to the room. I should be able to load the marker then.
Join me. Together we can stop this hive mind. We can end this nightmare at last.
Sorry, Isaac. I couldn't let him go through with it. I suppose I should thank you for finding the marker. We even managed without help from the USM Valor. Thank you for helping me find it, by the way. My department's been looking for this place for a long time. See what Kine didn't know was? It was the government's mess to begin with. This whole planet is one big experiment. The marker? This divine relic? Made by man. They reverse-engineered it a couple of hundred years ago from the real marker, a true alien artifact recovered on Earth. They dug it up, studied it, and they made it their own. Then they brought it to Aegis 7 and activated it. And you've seen the result. The stuff of nightmares. They sealed the system, and no one would have been the wiser. But then the CEC blunders in and starts tearing the planet apart. The experiment was still alive. Kine was right about the hive mind. The marker would contain it, but that doesn't matter now, does it? I have the marker, and this entire system can go to hell. For what it's worth, you did a great job, Isaac. See you around. Or maybe not.
Isaac, Nicole, I need you to help me. Help us, now! I'm in the flight control room. Please, Isaac, hurry! Please! I love you.
As you can see, we've just passed the 7 a.m. mark, which means 2 hours to go. Apparently means minimize my game automatically.
Really you? I never thought we'd be together again. God,
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry for what I did. I never wanted to hurt you. You need to get it back now, Isaac. You can pilot the shuttle remotely from here. Make us whole again. Make us whole again.
Escape pod away, crew shuttle USG-09. Repeat, shuttle has ejected escape pod.
It doesn't matter. She can't escape her fate. None of us can. Here it comes. I'll reprogram the shuttle so we can fly down to the colony. God, we're so close, Isaac. Now go, get on the shuttle. I'll meet you there. Fly down to the colony. God, we're so close, Isaac. Now go, get on the shuttle. I'll meet you there.
Thank you.
You're doing the right thing, Isaac. We're together now. The way it always should have been. I knew you'd come back for me. Nothing can stop us now. Off the shuttle.
Isaac, the marker needs to be returned to the pedestal chamber. Use the loader to bring it there and place it on the pedestal. Replace what was taken and make us whole again.
Thank you.
looking for a battery lying around to shove into the thing. I don't know.
This is Sergeant Newman, PSEC. We've lost all the shuttles. One of them just took off and came straight back down and crashed into the bay. Took a couple of hundred people and all the remaining shuttles with it. If anyone can hear this, do not land. Do not land. I don't think I'm blind in this case. Normally those things are pretty obvious. Is there one in the shuttle? No. Thank you.
area. Security has been notified.
Thank you.
Security has been notified.
Thank you.
Isaac, you're almost there. You'll have to restore power to the bridges to move the marker through this area. Look for a control station at the end of the maintenance tube.
Entering zero gravity.
Thank you.
exiting zero gravity.
Yeah.
Thank you, Isaac. I always believed in you. I knew you'd return to me. We are whole again, Isaac. We are whole.
Emergency. Geo-orbital gravity tethers offline. Tectonic load released. Impact imminent. Evacuate this area immediately.
About everything. I wish I could just talk to someone. It's all falling apart here. I can't believe what's happening. It's strange. Such a little thing. In the end, it all comes down to this one little thing. I didn't want it to end like this. I really wanted to see you again. Just once. I loved you. I always loved you. Oh my god.
Thank you.
Isaac, it's me. I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry.
Well then, there you have it, folks. That was Dead Space. Not a moment too soon. It is currently 8:13 a.m., which means we have just enough time to do another run through V, as promised. Will be in the bags. Also, very thanks to a anonymous donor who donated $10 within the last 1 or 2 hours or so, which brings our total up to about 70. Oh, hey, I can make the credits go faster. Sorry, whoever it is getting special thanks. Me one moment, we'll get to our regularly scheduled V speed run in air quotes. Alrighty, similar to last time, I'm going to be placing a bet against myself where for every death in my exhausted state, I'll be donating 10 cents to the kids. Last time, I believe we had about 36 minutes with 99 deaths, so we'll see how much 24 hours of video game playing actually takes out of a person. Alrighty, here goes nothing. Of course, I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't point out that it is not too late to donate. If you go to ascreps.com/extralife, you can show the kids at Johns Hopkins Children's Center that you care about them. One thing I learned during this stream is that if you take away all of my energy, you take away all of my will to be a talkative person. So far it seems pretty normal. I don't feel like I'm doing particularly better or worse than my usual.
We'll be right back.
Real question is, how lost am I going to get in the overworld this time? Here's where the sloppy deaths start. Super Gravitron goes.
Hey,
Eh, I don't know. We'll see the count at the end. I'm sure that'll still be the hardest room according to the stats. Actually uncover that teleporter, I'm gonna use it this time. Actually, the funnier thing would be if I forgot a trinket in this room. All right, fingers crossed, everyone. Oh. All right, that's funny. I did get all the trinkets, so... You don't have that blunder to look forward to. Feels like this one flew by, but it could just be how tired I am. Come on. Okay. This should be interesting. Oh, wow. That's actually a record time. Although I did have more deaths. And the Gravitron was not the room with the most deaths. Interesting. Weird. Anyway, we do still have 10 minutes left, and you know what that means. We still have time to blow our Super Hexagon levels 1 through 3 time out of the water. For a few minutes.
Super Hexagon.
Load up the stopwatch here. All right, and the clock starts now.
Again.
Remember, the time to beat here is 7.5 minutes.
Mine.
Levels 1 through 3.
Triangle. Game over. Begin.
Level 2.
Pentagon. Game over.
And level 3? You're really gonna have a perfect run of this? I hope not.
Game over again.
That would be scary. Wasn't even running. That was like 4 minutes at most. So basically a little over half the time it took originally. So what's the lesson we learned from that? Is it the secret to speedrunning challenging games is just not sleep? I don't know. At any rate, I do owe the kids at Johns Hopkins Children's Center $10.10. So I'll make that donation shortly after the show ends. I'm going to bed. Good night.